Welcome to a proof of the alternate exterior angles converse. This theorem states that if two lines are cut by a transversal and alternate exterior angles are congruent, then the lines are parallel. So if angle 1 is congruent to angle 8, or angle 2 is congruent to angle 7, the two lines would be parallel. And we want to prove this theorem. The proof of this theorem is based upon the corresponding angles converse postulate, which states that if two lines are cut by a transversal and corresponding angles are congruent, then the lines are parallel. Remember, a postulate does not have to be proved, it's assumed to be true. So we're going to use this postulate to prove the alternate exterior angles converse. So here's our proof. Transversal T cuts L and M, and we're given that angle 1 is congruent to angle 8. So this angle here is congruent to this angle here. So let's talk about our strategy. Our ultimate goal is to get corresponding angles congruent, and therefore we can use the corresponding angles converse postulate. So looking at our diagram, we have two options. Notice that angle 5 and angle 8 are vertical angles and therefore congruent, as well as angles 1 and 4. So using the fact that vertical angles are congruent, we can state that corresponding angles would be congruent and therefore the lines would be parallel. So let's go ahead and give it a try. We'll start by stating the given information. T cuts L and M with angle 1 congruent to angle 8. Let's go ahead and use angle 5 and angle 8 as our vertical angles. We can say that angle 8 is congruent to angle 5, and our reason is that vertical angles are congruent. And this falls into place very quickly because now we can use the transitive property to state that angle 1 is congruent to angle 5. Again, notice how if angle 1 is congruent to angle 8 and angle 8 is congruent to angle 5, these are connected and we can state that angle 1 is congruent to angle 5. Again, our reason is the transitive property. And if angle 1 is congruent to angle 5, angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles, and therefore line L is parallel to line M. This is by the corresponding angles converse postulate. And we have our proof. I hope this was helpful.